Hey, what up, guys? In today's video, we're ranking my favorite shows I've watched throughout 2023. I've watched a lot of them. A lot of you guys probably saw them with me. And I want to rank all of them from worst to best. I'll just say it's not based on writing per se. Writing does play a factor, but it's more just my personal enjoyment. So, with that being said, let's hop into it. Starting off at dead last, we got Hell's Paradise. This show is absolute trash. I already made a whole video about how I felt about the show. It has insanely wasted potential with certain characters, terrible rush character development, boring ass side characters. The only good thing about this show is the world building, but other than that, this show just did too much wrong in my eyes. Answer yourself this question: do you remember any characters' names other than Gabby Morrow? If you like the show, that's fine, but for me, I just personally didn't enjoy it. Number 13, we got Heavenly Delusion, obviously. I don't think Heavenly Delusion is a bad show by any stretch, but I also don't think it's great either. The twist at the end was definitely cool, and I do agree there were some good moments, but the show's problem is absolutely how forgettable it is. I can at least remember Gabby Mara's name. I cannot remember a single character's name from Heavenly Delusion, and neither can you. I only watched the show a few months ago, and in a few years' time, I doubt I'll remember a single thing from the show. Cyberpunk Edgerunners is one of the most breathtaking worlds in anime. Everywhere you look, you can tell a lot of thought and care went into everything. I actually love the art style, and the soundtrack was also awesome. I just think it suffers from how short it is. It was extremely hard for me to care about any of the side characters because of how little they were built up. It was more just a focus story on how life is like in this world. And if you're someone like me who just doesn't care about that kind of stuff as much, you won't enjoy it as much as others, which is fine. I definitely don't think the show is bad. I just feel it suffers from its short runtime. I've only watched one season of this show in 2023, but I thoroughly enjoyed it. I had watched the first two episodes of Spy X Family season 2, but after I started watching this show, I just realized Love is War is just a better version of Spy X Family. I laughed multiple times almost every episode. Overall, a very welcome change of pace to a funny, heartwarming story. Tokyo Revengers seasons 1 and 2 are such a nice breath of fresh air from what I usually watch. The main character is an actual beta who's good at nothing, yet his sheer willpower and determination makes you naturally gravitate towards him. This show tries to balance a lot of side characters, but in my opinion, they balance it really well. This show could potentially be higher on the list, but season 3 recently came out, and for some reason, I just can't be bothered to watch it. I think the reason is this show suffers from being extremely repetitive. How many times must you go back before something actually works? I just found it boring. I just recently finished Arcane. It is the last thing I've watched in 2023, and I gotta say, it was pretty good. Pretty short, but season 2 is coming, so it should be very interesting with the war arc that I'm assuming we're gonna get, considering the last episode was them about to start a war, killing all the council members. The show, I think, after episode 5, like 6, 7, 8, 9, were super fucking good. 1, 2, 3, and 4 are still pretty good, though, with 3 being really good. It was very interesting also to see Jinx, like she's actually like going full schizo in some of these scenes, which was pretty fun to see. I've never seen a character done like her before, so overall, very fun. I enjoyed it. Fullmetal Alchemist Brotherhood is the highest rated anime on all of IMDb. Now, personally, I don't feel it's the greatest anime ever, but I definitely see the appeal. This show has one of the biggest cast of characters in any show I've ever seen, and it balances them all out almost perfectly. Every character is super fun and lovable, and in my opinion, that's why it's so successful. The show is extremely funny and made me laugh in almost every episode. My only issue with Fullmetal is the fact that it does nothing the best in my eyes, but it also seemingly does nothing wrong, so you gotta respect it. Overall, it was quite the experience, and I'm very glad I watched it. Bakugan Season 2 is the absolute definition of pure fun. It's Bakugan at the end of the day, and it definitely has its flaws, but my god, when Bakugan's at its best, it's one of the most enjoyable things one could experience. This season also had no CGI, thank god, and was just jam-packed with nonsense and great fights. Overall, if you haven't seen Bakugan, you've got to experience it. It's one of the most unique things one could witness. Demon Slayer Season 3 came out swinging straight out the gate, and it was not fucking around. Unlike the previous season, episode 3 had already whipped out the upper demons out of absolutely nowhere. It obviously looked flawless with there being Demon Slayer, and the peak moments were undoubtedly peak. Season 3 overall, though, as the season was worse than season 2, and mine and a lot of other people's minds. Both new Hashiras had less screen presence than Tengen or even Rengoku in my mind, and my god, upper 4 and 5 were so boring and forgettable. The season just felt like they had to rush out these upper moons to make room for the actual good ones. Another problem was the fact that even though upper 4 and 5 were both stronger than Gitaro, overall they felt weaker because the fight wasn't as close. In season 2, it took everything everyone had just to barely win against them. In season 3, upper 5 gets absolutely fisted by Muichiro, and upper 4 didn't put up the best fight against Tanjiro and the others. Even with all these issues, though, the season overall is still very hype and better than most animes. Vinland Saga Season 2 is an absolute masterclass in how to have great writing. Let me just start off by saying, if you thought Season 2 of Vinland Saga was boring, you probably are the same person that eats Subway Surfers and all your TikToks to keep your teeny brain engaged. Season 2 shows a completely new version of Thorfinn, completely unlike anything we saw in Season 1. He starts off the season as an empty, broken man, completely lost without purpose, and by the end of the season, he's a new, revitalized man with purpose once more. Overall, the season was great. If you haven't seen Vinland Saga, I cannot recommend it enough. Overall, on this list, Breaking Bad is definitely the most polished and flawless project here, but just because it may be the best written, it doesn't make it my favorite thing I've seen this year. Breaking Bad is a masterclass of how to write a great story, and I don't think anyone's denying that. Breaking Bad has an excellent cast of great actors and a brilliant script to work with. The emotional moments hit hard, the tense moments make you hold your breath, and the plot twist will have you out of your seat. Overall, a close to perfect show, although I did enjoy Three Things slightly more than Breaking Bad this year. After watching Blue Lock Season 1, I genuinely think this show has potential to be my favorite show of all time. For me, the most important factor on if I like a show or not is the cast of characters. I like characters who stand on business and look cool doing it. Blue Lock decided they're gonna have almost every character look like a Giga Chad. People obviously share my sentiment as it's the highest selling manga of 2023, even above things like JJK and One Piece. Blue Lock also is one of the few shows where I was fiending for each episode to come out week to week. The cast is awesome and the show is super hype overall. I truly believe by the time it's fully animated, it'll be my favorite show of all time. In my opinion, JJK Season 1 was honestly just pretty decent, but I didn't think it was anything special. I honestly didn't care much that Season 2 was coming out, but oh my god. After seeing Season 2, it had gone from a show I barely cared about to, at the time recording this, definitely in my top 3. Remember how I said I love characters who stand on business? This season displays so many absolute goats. Gojo, Sukuna, and my personal favorite, Toji. This season had so many absolute peak episodes and moments. It also has some of the best animated fights and sequences I've ever seen in anime. If it keeps at this level, or even close to it in the future and animated, it will go down in history as being one of the best animes to ever be released. Death Note is one of the first shows I reacted to on my channel, and I could not have picked a better show to watch. This is one of those shows almost every anime fan has watched and respects for a good reason. The first 25 episodes of Death Note are some of the tightest, most perfect writing in any form of media. The pure genius cat-mouse rivalry between Light and L is one of the most intriguing things I've ever seen. I have a very Ooga Booga brain. Action and cool fights are one of my favorite things in anime, but this show is so good it didn't even need any cool fights to keep me engaged. It also introduces Light, one of the most complex and best written characters in fiction. Even though the second part of the show isn't as good as part one, it's still really good and honestly has one of my favorite endings in anime. I was depressed for days after Light died in the finale. Almost no other show has made me feel such strong emotions days after watching. Overall, Death Note, I believe, was the peak of my 2023 watch list.